His word is alive and it is well. Okay? It will flow through your veins if you allow it to. I don't get how people allow their Bibles to sit on their nightstand. They don't even give God the time of day. But as soon as they wake up in the morning, the first thing they want to do is scroll on TikTok. You don't think God deserves that time? God deserves just as much time as you give to your phone and more. Okay? If I feel like I'm on my phone or doing something too much, I'm like, this time could be spent with God. I get more out of getting into his word than anything else in this world. So what are you really wasting your time on? Get to know who God is. Get into his word and stop questioning everything. Because he'll teach you the reasonings for his warnings and for him sending his ministers and his messengers and his people out to tell people what's going on and to warn people about what's going on is to help you to get to salvation, to help you get into your word, to help you get form a relationship with Christ. Because let me tell you something. I didn't know a lot whenever I first started walking with Christ. I didn't know a lot about what was going on in the word. I had to dive into it to figure it out. And to be honest, I didn't figure it out. God showed me. He opened up my eyes to be able to see, my ears to be able to hear, my mind to be able to comprehend the things of the spirit. He does that if you allow him to. You can't go into the word with a carnal mind thinking, oh, well, if God does this with a parable, what is he talking about with the fig tree? Like, stop being those philosophers who want to question everything. Just go into it knowing that, God, you know what? I'm ready to give my life to you. You know, come into my heart, come into my mind. Help me, Lord. You know, we have got to get to that point. You have got to get to that point because God is not playing. His wrath is serious and he is very serious about it. He is not playing. The same way he destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah, the same way he destroyed the villages in Egypt because Pharaoh wouldn't let his people go. He is not playing, and that was back then. If he's talking about this generation being the most rebellious, the most stubborn, oh, he coming with vengeance for his people. He is not playing, okay? He is the same God that destroyed those cities, the same God that told Lot and his wife, don't look back. His wife looked back. What happened to her? He does not play. When he says something, he means it. So y'all better stop playing and get serious about this walk because things are imploding. The world is imploding. Turn to Christ. Turn to him now, not next year, because we don't have all that time to get it right. Turn about face.